Turn your pain into power and your purpose into prosperity. So today I want to share with you how I created my beautiful sacred altar, a Christian altar, where you can go and pray and fellowship with God and get in alignment with the kingdom of God and do all of your spiritual work, but in one particular place. Now there's a couple of reasons why you would like to create an altar. Well, first of all, it is scriptural to have an altar as a believer. And really, it is a place where you can consider it a point of contact. So let's talk about some of the benefits of creating a sacred space in your home, such as an altar. Well, an altar is a wonderful place to put all of your spiritual energy in an atmosphere in one part of your home where you know that it is sacred. Now don't get me wrong, your entire home should be a sacred space. But ideally, when you have a particular place which is a point of contact, that energy just gets stronger and stronger the longer that you use it for prayer and for fellowshipping with the Holy Spirit. And then after a while, you know, you will infuse your whole atmosphere, the whole entire energy of your home with that same energy that you are building up at that altar, at your prayer altar. So it's, to me, I just love knowing that I have a particular place that once I'm there, I know that's just my place with God. I'm not doing anything else there. I'm not thinking about anything else. I'm not focusing on anything else but the Holy Spirit and being in contact and fellowship and praise and worship with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So join me and I'm going to show you how I create my altar and you can see how simple it is. So this is my space that I'm using for my altar, and basically what it is an old console that I had years ago. It kind of broke and it was not really functioning anymore for the purpose I had purchased it for, so I decided to use it as an altar. I like the fact that it still has a little glimmer that shows through my lace, so it gives me a little bit of bling, and I like that. So all I do is just cover it with lace. Now you can use anything, really and truly. You can, let me turn this around. You can actually use a small table. You can use a small desk. You can get very creative. Basically, you just want something that's not going to take up a whole lot of space, and you can have it in your room. This is my living room, so I have this in my living room, and it's not taking up too much space. I'm still able to open up my door, and guests can come in, and it's not being disturbed. So what I want to show you is some of the things that you can add to create your altar. Of course, you want to have your candles. So I have these beautiful scented candles. As for me, fragrance is important. the middle says peace. So words are vibrational. So you wanna, if you have anything that says something, you want it to say what you want to receive, right? So speaking of words, let me just show you this too. So this is a pretty sparkly sign that just says celebrate. And it reminds me to celebrate life. So I have that here. As you see, I have a gold cross, a brass cross, and so I have that on the wall. So if you want, you can put a cross if you like. And then now you can, I do like to have fresh flowers, and you don't have to have a bouquet this large. You can just take one fresh flower or a couple flowers and put them in a smaller vase, right? But if you like, you can have a beautiful bouquet. And for me, I do like the white flowers. I find that the white flowers evoke a sense of purity and cleansing, and it's just a vibration that is pure, you know. And I pray many of my prayers, and meditations, I talk about the light of God's love, the light of divine love. I talk about light a lot. So I do like the idea of having the white flowers, because to me it's just a physical expression of that light of God's love. So then I have these mini books, and this one is Jesus is Running the Race with Jesus, Jesus and Success. This one is The Prayer of Jabez. And then I also have the New Testament, Psalms and Proverbs. So the other thing I have, and you don't have to have this on the altar, but Jesus Calling is, to me, one of the best devotional books ever written. And by it's by Sarah Young, and I tell all my clients to make sure that they get this devotional. It is beautiful. If you want to have a personal relationship with Jesus and feel like you are, that he's with you every day, then you want to definitely invest in Jesus Calling. And this is a cross that was given to me by a very special friend, Jennifer Crumpley. And she gave me this cross. It's a special prayer cross. It's designed for you to put your fingers through, to hold the cross while you're praying. And it's made out of a special wood. It was created by, I think this one was created by monks. And it's just very high vibrational. And again, because I'm using this on a regular basis, I'm infusing this cross with my energy. And actually the energy, God's energy, God in me. And the high vibrational frequency of prayer is being infused in this beautiful cross. So as I hold on to this cross when I pray, sometimes when I'm praying in the spirit, I'm led to take the cross and hold it to my heart, or to like gesture them, rubbing it around my head. And I just feel like maybe there's something going on that I need to cleanse some thoughts, or maybe I need to clear my heart or whatever. So this is beautiful. And what happens too is, once you have something like this that you use as a prayer tool, if you will, a prayer instrument, what happens is you can use it as a point of contact after a while, because it becomes just like holy water. It becomes so infused with spiritual energy that you can take this with you and lay hands on someone who's sick, and you can actually have them be healed. And this is my pillow. So I use that pillow for prayer. And basically, what I do is I light my candles.
as I'm lighting my candles, I'm actually, I start praying, and I generally will start praying in the spirit and just ushering in the Holy Spirit. So I'll light all my candles and I'll start just praying in the spirit, just preparing my heart. And that's it. This is your Christian altar. You don't have to put anything here, like ancestors, pictures of ancestors, and pictures of people who have been deceased. It's not about that. This is just for you and for the Holy Spirit, and for you to have that time with God. So I hope this blesses you. God bless you. Meet me at sharingofbliss.com and get your 7-day mini course. And I'll talk to you soon. Love you. Bye-bye.
Ready to heal your emotions, transform your body, and pursue your purpose? Then join me, Coach Carmen, at www.sharingthebliss.com and grab your free Get Started Now gift bundle. Among other things, it includes my spiritually enlightening 7-day mini course and some of my most popular, amazing raw food dessert recipes. Look forward to seeing you there.